Here we are asking from the user to enter the sequence. Next is N1, that is equals to input, enter the range, that means range is to be entered by the user. Now we need to give the subplot function, that is subplot 2 1 1. Next we need to give the title, so title we will give as given sequence. That means here first we are plotting the first sequence, that is given sequence over here. Now we are using the flip function to perform the folding of the given sequence, so that for that the function used is n equals to minus flip r n1, then we will take x equals to flip r flip lr. That means this indicates that flip array left to right. Same way we are using over here flip LR, that is flipping of the sequence from left to right. Here we are sequence using x1. Now we need to give the position of this flip sequence. So we are taking subplot 2, 1, 2. That means this will divide the outputs window into number of rows 2, number of column 1, and it will plot it at the second position. And to plot it in the discrete form, we need to use stem and x. That means now we are plotting the x sequence. We have plotted previously x1. We need to give this the title, that is our flipped sequence. So this is the instruction lines or code, MATLAB code, for performing the folding of the given sequence. So this project is titled to be given as folding of the sequence. So folding. Now seeing the command window, first it is asked to enter the sequence. So we need to enter the sequence over here, which is we are going to enter as 1 3 7 in the square bracket. Now it will ask the range to us. So first of all, let us enter the range. Here there are 3 elements, so I'm entering the range 1s to 3, that means 1 2 3. Now it will give us the flipped sequence. So as you can see in this figure, our given sequence and the flipped sequence is indicated. So the given sequence, as you can see, is 1, 3, 7, and the flipped sequence is at the -2. Okay. So as you can see over here, the signal is not indicating over here. That means there is some mistake. So we can identify the error. That means over here we have not written this 10. So it will not plot this discrete function for us. So we need to write down over here stem and 1x1. So at the runtime you can identify the error based on this. So now let us try again how it will give the output to us. So by changing this, as you can see, now the given sequence is indicated. So as you can see, the given sequence is ended as 1, 3, 7. So the first position the value taken is 1, the second position value taken is 3, and the third position value taken is 7. And by flipping, as you can see, now this second position will give to as -2, this 3 will be at -3, and this 1 will be at -1. So here you can see the signal is reversed or flipped to the original sequence. So this is the practical of performing the folding of the given sequences. So at the runtime, you can identify the errors in between and you can change and correct the code for the proper output. Okay.
In this session, we are going to see the basic functions using MATLAB platform based on the practicals. So in this session, we are going to see the practical of shifting the input sequence using the MATLAB code. So we will see how we can shift according to the number of values given by the user, and using the MATLAB code, how we can generate the output for the given input sequence. So let's start with that.
Okay, so now using the MATLAB code, let us perform the shifting of the input sequence. So for that, first of all, we'll have the data which is to be entered by the user. So we'll use the first instruction line, that is x1 equals to input. We need to make it enter by the user. So let us indicate the message enter the sequence. So this sequence is to be entered by the user. So first message is enter the sequence. Next is we need to enter the range. So n1 equals to input. Enter the range. Next, we need to make it shift. So s equals to input, that will indicate that how many number of shift sequences to be used. So here input message is to be displayed as enter the number of, or as enter the number for shift sequence. So this indicates that how many number of shift are used to indicate the final shifted sequence. Now we need to give the position by using the subplot function. So here I am using subplot 2, 1, 1. Then to plot it discrete, we need to use the function stem, that will give stem n1 x1. Now the title is to be given. So over here, title is given sequence. Now the shifted sequence is to be given by the function, that is n2, another variable with n1 plus s. This line indicates that we have given n1 over here. So that is to be entered with the number of shift given by the user, and it is to be stored in the variable n2. And now we need to plot that. So for that, we will give the position subplot 2, 1, 2, and for that, to plot it discrete, we will use stem function. So stem n2, we have already plotted n1. Now we are going to plot n2. Over here n2 x1 is there. And we need to give the title as title shifted sequence. We which is to be plotted. Okay, now this program is done. Let us run this to check whether the shifting of input sequence is done or not. So let us give it a title, that is shifting. Just save it like that. Now it is asked to enter the sequence to us in the command window. So let us enter the sequence, that is we are entering 2, 4, 6. It is asked us to enter the range. We are entering the range 1s to 3, and it is asked to enter the number of shift sequence. Let me add that 3. That means I want the shift by 3. Let us see how it is plotted. So here, as you can see, the sequence is plotted as 1, 2, 4, 6. That means at first position, 2 is there. At second position, 4 is there. And at the third position, 6 value is there. And we need to shift it by 3. So in all these values, 3 is to be entered. So 1 plus 3, it will give 4. 2 plus 3 will give you instant 5. 3 plus 3 will give you instant 6. So this is shifted by 3 sequence. Okay. So is our given sequence, that is original sequence that we have entered, and this is the shifted sequence by 3. You can change the shifting sequence by any of the number, and according to that you will get the shifted sequence. So I hope that shifting of the input sequence is clear to you now using the MATLAB code.
I hope that this practical using the MATLAB platform is clear to you now, and keep practicing the different functions in the MATLAB software. Thank you. Thank you once again.